spot on the trapezius area. Look at trapezius. What meridians do we have running through here? We have cold butter. Sanjar. So GB, SJ, SI. See the effect it has. It's even just massaging here is moving the shoulder. Some shoulder problems can be attributed to the clavicle and to the first and second ribs. They're called the bucket handle. Elderly people, they get shoulder pain, but mostly it's a collapse, it can be a collapsed lung. So the lung can just drop down, half a centimetre or whatever, and it's pulling on the attack. You've had that with
pneumothorax, yeah.
Pneumothorax, and then you think, shoulder pain, shoulder pain, and then suddenly the breathing changes. And you think, so another thing as well, the gallbladder, the phrenic nerve. Down here, can run up, and so they have this traveling pain after the heat. So if you've got people with shoulder pain after the heat, the gallbladder seems to. Yeah. How's that feel, Paddy?
Yeah.
It's comfortable.
Yeah.
Strong. When you take their arm, remembering how far can he lift his arm, like how frozen is that arm, how bad affection are the joints, do I have to lower myself? And then I'm going to work the posterior deltoid here, use the tricep region. So again, I'm working the yang channels.
And why would you include the arm?
Well, remember what we discussed yesterday, we have tendons going into the joint, tendons going into the joint. So if I need massaging the muscle groups and affecting tendons going in. We also have the small intestine channel here, so we need to warm that up. Teres major and teres minor are two of the most damaged muscle groups. And remember we said 70% of shoulder pain is muscular, 30% is joint related, statistically. And it's the opposite way around the hip. If you remember the treatment yesterday, the hip, there was a lot of thing around the bone, wasn't there? And getting into the bone, and on the bone, and pressing into the bone. Even on the thigh, we were pressing into the bone. Here we're manipulating all the muscles. There's actually very little you see when you press something into the joint. It's all muscle stretching. Here, tweefer. You can do tweefer like this, but I find it's not as relaxing when you move. So this is where you need good flexibility with your wrist. Sheep helps to keep everything even, so he's wearing a jumper or a short sleeve. The terrain that you're treating is uneven, pretty much even to be on. Then I do Yijia Chan Tui, which is a variation of Tui. Is kind of variation of the Yijia Chan. So I'm working into small intestine 9 and 10. These teres root muscles. Again, I can do it this way also. Zhi, finger, Z-H-I, Chan, C-H-A-N.
Yeah, we're right.
There may be some things that I miss out whenever I teach this, there's always that I'm going to do that, but there's so many things in this.
So this will treat the neck and the shoulder then?
We've not covered the neck.
Okay, you just the shoulder. Yeah.
You should really start with the neck first.
Yeah.
I'm going to show you this because it's a lot more.
Great, yeah.
Excuse me. Then from here, you can support Paddy's arm if I want. He's on the stool. So if he's a much lower, and from here, then I can roll. Remember that pain that's the other hand?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So we can deal with the same, the other way we can deal with that through this. I can also obviously work here. If he's a very big, strong, like very muscular person, rolling like this may be very tall, so I can't get my gun foot to work because I have to like change to step back. But if I need to get into him, then I can use this as a shorter distance to travel for him. And it's much stronger.
It's just you.
That's what I mean.
Yeah.
I think Clint Eastwood in there. Then we can use three this way.
Lack of oxygen really, isn't it? Isn't that?
It's the junctions we talk about, and they just collect rubbish.
Mm.
Like around your wrists, you know, you do the hand and arm routine.
Almost calcium deposited and calcium, yeah.
Dead blood.
Yeah.
And you eat a very salty diet.
Mm.
And it just, as you know, it just collects. I can also then, once I've done that, so I'm softening, this is all softening the joint. I can also roll at the front, yeah. And I can move. So, with both sides, I'm massaging, I can move this way. So I can open up this joint this way. I have to move my body. I mean, yesterday some of you I noticed you were like doing these manipulations and I'm wondering why it doesn't feel the same. But you've got to move your body. Right? You have to move. No point me going, can you see what's happening to me?
Mm-hmm.
So this particular style between that I've been doing maybe 12 years, and it's been about 15 years, 17 years doing Chinese medicine, 20 years doing some form of massage since 1985. And I can tell you I was more tired in oil massage to from 1995 to 1997, the 2 years before I moved here. It was tiring. Because no one taught me about posture and movement. And also it's kind of like if you've ever gone ice skating and you're on the rink, you're constantly fighting the oil, it's slippery and it's like, oh, it's just exhausting. We can also grasping, yeah. Napa, needed. I'll show you a variation on that in a minute. The other side of this as well is we have a section in the deltoid where there is two gaps, two spaces, tendon attachments. These are the areas we want to pluck, open up. Because remember, plucking tendons can, this will be large intestine 15 and 16, is that right? Yeah, 15, 16, 14 will do. These two areas, collateral from improving joint health. But still, it could be a joint problem. It might not be a muscular problem. Yeah. So, well, then we can get into these spaces using Yijichan, Yijichan Tui. Strong?
Okay.
Yeah, it's bearable.
Yeah.
Tui at the front of the shoulder. Come down the bicep as well, you can do that. Am I missing anything, Janet?
No, you're fine.
Some students, they have to have it exactly the way I told it last time. So, in general, warming here. Rolling, yeah, rolling, rolling, rolling. Here, rolling, rolling, rolling. Go high, sorry, rolling, rolling. And then we are using the points, 9 and 10, small intestine. Get into here, large intestine, 15 and 16. Use this, it's very good for breaking up scar tissue. Strong, having it out.
Strong.
Here, if they're a big person, use your tweet, this motion. Feel all that grittiness in that tendon junction I was showing you. Yeah. Then we come more to sort of the manipulation part of this. You have to kind of, you have to be careful. It depends very much on the state of the person's joint. I will actually show you an extra manipulation. From here, what I like to do is do this. Well, actually, what you can do is take your arm if you're able to also, and do this double loafer position. If they can't raise their arm, you can just do them this position. And it should feel warm and relaxing. Okay. Yes, boss. I can then drop down into sofa if I want from here, which is like your Nyanfa when you're doing your the same thing, but on the margin of this. And then tap, G flat, to the squares, A flat. If this person's shoulder is particularly frozen, or not frozen but really quite stuck, you can take this position here and compress. So I'm using my forearms, dropping them, and then let's lift it and swallow it strong. And we're comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
This is working the deltoid. Compressing brings blood in, pushes deeply out. Mobilizations you can do if the person's comfortable and they can move their arms. It's just like an ache, a general ache. It's not really a restricted movement, it's been bothering them. Yeah.
Heat's coming in.
Heat's coming in now, great. So, There are yofa manipulations, dolfa, which is the shaking, and there's bashofa, and there's one extra one that I might add in as well, which you haven't learned, which is quite good. If the person is restricted, I start at this level with my yofa. So I'm using the wrist here to just gauge the engagement. So I can shake his arm just by moving the wrist. Yeah, so I can get this motion going. It's a little less impacting on the shoulder. And then stretch it out. From a stretching point of view, traction point of view, first one I teach you is elbow to elbow. So my elbow comes in this way. I lock and then I bring this hand over the top. I create a triangular shape. So if my elbow is in his elbow, my hand is in my elbow. My other hand is in his wrist. Now for men, we can bring the elbow in to the chest. For women, we then what we do is we raise, you want to pull it to the side here. And then what you want to do is drop your shoulders, get into your calf muscles, into your toes, settle in, and then push. Embrace your chest back. You feel the pull there to the stretch. And then if you're a ballerina, this is why you need to do a lot of lunging, the jigging, so you can learn to stand on the toes. Okay, so that's what that's doing is pulling the joint this way, and stretching here, and then the latissimus dorsi and the joints. The second stretch. Second sort of one as well. If you do the same thing, similar thing, but this time using a clamp connection. So if the person is particularly tall, you can't get in and that's too much for you. If you clamp your hand out, you have to bring your elbows in. Watch what happens. You see? Now I can stretch it further. Variation, I don't think I showed you guys last time. Well, show the
meaning.
We just did that one. This is a different one. Okay. Okay, yeah.
I'm doing good. It's not bad.
You're at the end of the
meeting now.
Okay. Okay, so there is time. The next one I haven't shown you, I don't think I'm going to show you, but it's pretty good. this is to open up the back of the shoulder. Okay. Now I remember this shoulder's had problems with it for years, and it's from an osteopath. I was at osteopath college when I was 23, and an osteopath put something underneath my arm and did this, and my arm has never been the same. So even good good osteopaths. Make mistakes. Yeah. In China they don't do it that way, they get the shoulder in to the person and they bring the arm up this way. And they don't pull, they just rotate the whole body. Yeah. So sometimes they'll brace this way. Now obviously intimacy can be an issue. Yeah? In China they don't care about, you know, breathing on your diabolic breath while I'm massaging you, or pushing the groin into you this way. They just don't care. So you just need to be very careful about how you do it. The main principle is, and you can use your hip this way and do the same thing. And the main principle is you move your whole body with it. It's not me pulling him. It's a gentle stretch. It should feel gentle. The pad will tell you if I do that, feels like I'm locking him.
Yeah.
Feels like I'm trying to choke him.
Mm-hmm.
I brace into him and move my whole body. It's nice, isn't it?
You're supporting the whole joint.
And
the
I'm also
spine.
The spine.
Yeah.
To stop him from rotating.
Yeah.
I do this.
Yeah.
Turning.
Yeah.
If I'm against the shoulder and I'm pushing in, and then I'm rotating. More stable. And it gets further.
Mm. So you're pressing the elbow really to help rotate a little bit.
I'm actually not just the elbow, it's not the body.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually the body I'm using. And I'm guiding.
Yeah, no pressure on that.
Okay.
Very good.
I should be able to do this motion. So that's an extra one that is from my older swing school. Now the one that people struggle with is the Tai Chi circling motion. So if I don't get to actually go this way. So, very basically, the principle is yoga rotation. So any of those of you who've been in a band who can twiddle a baton, that's the basis of this. Okay. So at a very basic level, more staying in contact with padded. Lifting, and as his hand drops, I'm grasping. Now, to support me, I use the other arm. By the way, I know he'll relax because now he feels the pressure on his wrist. Whereas here he's uncertain. He's certain here. Then when I get to here, there's a chance that I let go. So if I have two now, it's more certain, and his body's more certain that he's been guided. There's a reason for this, because we do a stroking, wiping motion. As the hand comes up in 12 o'clock, and this hand comes over, wipes down the movement. It stays there until the hand rotates down to 6 o'clock and drops. Comes around 12 o'clock, I'm already bringing this arm over the top. Grasp it using my fingers coming over my hand, wipe, up and down, wipe. And then I use my body. And I can do the more yin meridians. And then when I change my direction, the more, yeah. Okay. I'll make it look easy, but it's well practiced. So when we get to that, I'll sit with you and make adjustments. But in the beginning, just get your partner to help you. And how they can help you is by keeping their arm really heavy, not by letting you lift it up. So let them really relax their arm. So as you guide it up, if Paddy tries to help me, I'm not going to learn anything. If I grasp here and then let the weight